Maybe you should talk.
What's up, y'all? We're here. So, right now, we're going to do just an experiment to see how the waterfall pour that we do works when using a quick setting resin. So today we're using Stone Coat Countertops Quick Set. It is a 1-to-1 ratio resin that you have about a 15-20 minute working time, and then it sets up within 2 hours. That's kind of bananas, and we don't know if this is going to work, but we're going to experiment with it for y'all today, right now, right here, today. Today, Jeffrey is the lovely artist. I'm just the narrator, but I'm going to be here in case he needs any backup.
If you can see, this is a very small canvas, so.
I think it's a 4x4.
Yeah.
So, when working with resin, no matter if it's a 1-to-1 or a 2-to-1 or whatever to whatever, it's very important that you measure out accurately, because I used to say this all the time, but getting into the lives, I don't really remember to say it anymore. But if you have too much hardener, then your piece may set up faster than you would like. And if you have too much resin, it may never set up at all.
Or vice versa. Like, you never know. Like, it could just be like, meh, we're supposed to have this. And it might not set up. Some parts might be sticky, some parts
may not be. Like, point is, measure accurately and make sure that when you mix your two parts together that it is completely mixed in well with each other. Because you could still, even if you measure accurately, end up with weak spots if you don't scrape the sides of your cup or the face and corners of the inside of your cup and the stir stick. Very important. With this quick setting resin, it's easy to get caught up in the fact that you don't have a lot of working time, and so you really want to pay attention to that when you're working with this kind of resin. Keep an eye on the clock. Once the two parts touch each other, that's when the clock starts.
No turning back.
15 to 20 minute working time. 20 minutes is probably absolute max. If you keep the resin on your substrate instead of in the cup. Today's colors are not blue diamond.
Yeah.
Oh, it is?
Blue diamond.
Oh, I thought you had turquoise. It is blue diamond. This color is very nice. It's metallic. It is by Just Resin. It is a paste. It is a metallic paste, and it is a gorgeous, gorgeous color. The other color Jeff is using is this one?
Stone Coat's white.
It is this white. It is by Stone Coat Countertops. It is their white base tint on their website. This is the main size that they sell this in. This is the main size that they sell this in. And I need to go find a charger for the laptop.
We've done this before. If you remember our first waterfall, and we did it using, I think, Art and Glow, and that still was a little bit longer working time than I would like for something like this. We definitely want this to set up faster so you don't have to baby it as much. So I was just kind of testing it to see if I just left it for a minute or two, not pour it right away, so it kind of sets up a little bit more, the work time. It's gonna be kind of like a negative pour piece, a negative whites on the sides and up at the top, and then I'm gonna pour the teal right here. I think I'm just gonna pour the teal all along here and just pick it up and let it tilt. Or I'm sorry, the white is just gonna go. I think I should just not do that yet, right?
Well, you know you're gonna wanna work with the lines, the drips, once they get down here, right?
That's what I'm hoping, that I don't have to. Okay. Because it sets up so fast.
Gotcha.
Those look like bruises so bad.
I'm sure.
All right. So what I want to do, let's do this. Let's make sure all this is here.
And just put a little stir stick to get up in those creases.
Tape up here to make sure that's all.
We're just using a regular masking tape for the edges of this piece.
Yeah, I would prefer to use blue tape, but we're seeing if this masking will work. But what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna pour right at the top and just keep pouring till it just drips.
We have the board that is the base covered in a white plastic, and it is set up on a slight angle, maybe 3 degrees.
Probably.
That's an E-sign.
I'll probably tilt it.
You're gonna have to.
A little more, because this is, yeah. Well, it's gonna have to. All right. So what I'll do.
When working with a fast setting resin like this, it definitely.
It's always different whenever you're. When you do it. I'm just gonna tilt this a lot because I want these drips to be a little bit bigger. I like to tilt it back just so that it kind of goes back kind of underneath your canvas so that it sticks to it. And what you can do, I don't think this is level because it's like going off to that side, which is kind of funky.
When working with resin, when it does something you didn't expect it to, the best advice we can give you is to just roll with it.
Yeah.
Make it part of the choice. So right now what Jeff's going to do is pull out some of that resin into a longer drip and allow the resin to fill that in.
Which I should have done in the first place. I should have done that with the white.
You should make that one the longest.
not a fan of this at all.
I think you should put more resin on the top.
Actually going back into it.
That looks fun. I like how soft that top is.
I'm not a fan of it going outside of it.
It's like something exploded or glass shattered and it's dripping down.
I'm gonna take one of these tiles out. I have a tile in underneath. I have two of them actually. See, it's just not. I wonder if I can just push that up there.
I think it's already wet, and so it's not gonna. It'll fill back in.
Yeah.
You're dripping. But that made a neat design element. And it may
not. It's just too much. I use too much resin.
Do you have any more of that blue left?
Yeah.
I just don't want to go to waste.
See, I should wait for it to sit. It's hot right now.
I like that. That looks like. Do you have another small square? When you can do another one.
Mm-hmm. Let me try this. Is that new camera?
Yeah. That's probably gonna.
I don't really care.
It's gonna get in on that.
It doesn't matter. I don't like this. This is hideous. It's heating up. I'm just doing it. It's not anything. Yeah, that's already set up. See, I wonder if you just wait. Stir it up, wait for a minute.
Like something's smoking.
What's that? Like, look at that.
Not even.
No, it's moving. This stuff smells. It heats up like that. But that's not moving. This stuff is still moving because we had it out. It's mm-hmm. It's really.
It's a good lesson on why you want to get it out of the cup.
Look at it like boiling up. Is that, I guess not. It's because it was setting.
Yeah. and you've moved it in itself. Like the outside sets first, and so when you move it, the inside is bulbousing. Bulbousing? Yeah. I don't know if that's a word. That is really pretty though, for
it
real.
Is. Yeah, that's fun. There's a divot. Wow.
Can you pick up some of like this outside? It's still so great that you can do that and not really worry about it falling back into that area because it's starting to set up.
Mm-hmm.
If you wanted to do that thing.
No, let's try to see what that looks like. Okay. Yeah, that doesn't. It's like a cow udder. That's so crazy why this stuff is set up and this isn't yet. Obviously, I just use way too much resin. And this stuff is already set up. Look at that. That's crazy. It's almost like you just need to tape it all the way off or pour it, pour your colors in here. Tilt it the opposite way so that it stays up here, and then till it fills up enough, and then you tilt it so then it all just goes off at the same time.
Yeah. It's like 5 minutes from when you could pull these sides off.
That's so crazy.
It's like,
I know, but I want to see what it looks like if it'll go down, like real slowly, like icing.
Right, I think you're about 5 minutes from that point. Or go ahead.
Look at that.
It's so clean.
Well, I think it's going to go down, like it's going to drip down, like. And I have a piece of silicone caulking underneath this so it holds it in place, or else if not, it would have definitely moved. Unless the oh, it came off. Yeah, see if I would have had that dry. It's coming down the sides a little, but it's still just on top. It's so difficult to make it clean. Because of the sides, like we need to figure out if we need to just put a line of caulking right here, just a straight line.
Could do it.
And that would definitely have a little border.
Are you gonna clean that up?
A little canal. I know. That's too much.
It's staying.
Yeah.
Which, after all, was the idea.
Do what?
Which was the idea.
Yeah. I know, right? It's like...
So. That's crazy. The top's still a little tacky. You saw it here, folks. In 20 minutes, pull that up. I just want to cut the cup away. Okay, hear me out. Okay.
Well, if you do that, put this on.
It's still too tacky to do that.
Hear me out. I think it'll stick to this paper.
Okay, still hear
Silicone
me.
Cup?
Kind of. Either like wrap it in cellophane or use that Tyvek tape or just squeeze some silicone out and coat it so that you can just go make shots.
Now you're getting crazy.
No.
Look at that. Yeah, it's going back over there. Let's put some heat on it. Put a little heat on it, it'll activate it, it'll accelerate it a little bit. Did that come down a little bit?
Mm-hmm.
It kind of did. It's so fun.
Are you going to do another one?
I don't know. But look, when you do that, it kind of expands. See it?
Mm-hmm.
When you reheat it, it'll do that.
Okay.
I think we just need to...
Let it set up a little bit?
Let it set up. Pour your... Have a good tilt and just pour it and, like, heat it up. And then let that... Let it, maybe let it drip.
Would you
do another one.
Out?
I don't know.
You could just do another one right here and tip it that way.
Is this live?
No, it's just recording.
All right, well, there you go. With the quick set, it doesn't, that's so crazy that it puts out like that. If you keep it in that cup, it'll definitely.
Paper activates it.
Yeah. And there's the frosting look I want.
Mm-hmm.
On both sides. Oh, it looks great over here.
Yeah, you can see it. Alright, y'all, on the next video, we will show you what this one turned out like. Till then, bye.
I said bye.